إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد أيها الناس اتقوا الله تعالى فالتقوى وقاية من العذاب وطريق إلى فوز والثواب قال تعالى واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. My brothers and sisters, would anyone believe that from the tiniest of Allah's creation the world has stopped in its tracks? Would anyone believe that from the most minute of Allah's creation, this creation, so small, Allah has stopped one of the biggest countries in the world? It has swept the world like a wind. No country is able to defend against it. No doctor or scientist knows how to prevent it. So as a result, feeble man picks up a thin mask to put over his face. And in this he hopes, which will protect him against fitna. A mask that he hopes, which will protect him over death. Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. My brothers and sisters, the Muslim in his iman believes that all dominion belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing happens in this creation except through his decree. So any good that happens in the creation is likely is a consequence of the goodness that mankind has done themselves. Or if there is any bad that happens in the creation, it is very likely that man has done this with their own hands. And throughout history, my brothers and sisters, mankind has trialed and error. They have fallen into trial and error. And we have realized and we have come to see with our own eyes that the further we are away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will continue to be patient over us, but His justice finally will prevail. And perhaps when His justice is established, even the whole globe will be afflicted. Allah says about Nuh alayhi salam, in quoting him alayhi salam, قَالَ لَا أَسِمَ الْيَوْمِ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمٍ. Today there is no protection from the command and the decree of Allah except for those who Allah has mercy on. وَحَالَ بَيْنُهُمَ الْمَوْجِ. And the waves swept them and overcame them. فَكَانَ مِنَ الْمُغْرَقِينَ. And all of them drowned. After 950 years of patience from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after 950 years of Allah not punishing them for their kufr and their sin, Allah's justice became apparent and the whole globe was affected by it. My brothers and sisters, today we live in a world where it is full of sin and oppression. We live in a world where it is full of sin and oppression. And as a result, even the best and the most pious of us will be afflicted by the tests that mankind is going through. But why, my brothers and sisters? Why is this all happening? There are two reasons, but they are actually part of one big collective problem that faces man and jinn. Number one, the hour is close. The hour is close to be established. Soon, iman will be reduced even more than it already is right now. In the globe, iman will soon be totally lifted. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Uddid sittun bayna yaday as-sa'ah." There are six things that I have counted that will happen before the hour is established. These will happen. There is no doubt about them. And he mentioned from them sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Mautan," a death, a plague, "Ya'khudh fiikum qu'aas al-ghanam," it will overtake you like a disease that kills sheep, falling dead, one by one. There is no stopping it from happening. And there was actually one incident that happened in the Prophet's mosque, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu said that we were sitting with the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one day, when he said, "Ya ma'ashul muhajireen, O people who have immigrated from Makkah, khisalun khamsun idha nazalan bikum." There are five things that are bound to happen. And when they happen, وَأَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ أَن تُدْرِكُوهُنَّ. And I seek refuge because of the severity. I seek refuge in Allah that you see any of them, O people from the Muhajirun? And he said, from them, Lam tadhhar al-fahisha, illegal intercourse, zina, lewdness, never becomes apparent in a group of people, fi qawmin qat, hatta yu'linu biha, to the extent that they start proclaiming it and they become proud of it. And it's this is the world that we live in, my brothers and sisters. As we see today, the Prophet ﷺ has described that illegal intercourse and zina and lewdness will become apparent and people will become proud of it and they will announce it. إِلَّا فَشَى فِيهِمْ الطَّاعُونَ, except that they will be afflicted with diseases and a sickness. وَالْأَوْجَعَ, and a chronic pain. الَّتِي لَمْ تَكُنْ مَدَدْ فِي أَسْلَافِهِمْ الَّذِينَ مَدَوْ قَبْلَهُمْ. They will be afflicted with a disease that was not known from the generation that came before them. A new pandemic will afflict them and it may never even be lifted. And then he went on to say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَن تَقُسُوا الْمِكْيَالُ وَالْمِيزَانُ, and they do not. And this is the world we live in today, my brothers and sisters, a world of economic worries. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will not begin to cheat one another in their business dealings and in their markets. They will not increase trickery so that rich people will become richer. Riba will not increase. Corruption will not increase. Bribery and fraud will not increase. Illa ukhidhu bis-sinin, except that they will be then punished and taken with years of starvation. Wa shiddatul ma'una, and a desperation will be given to them. Wa jawri sultani alayhim, and the evil and the most oppressive rulers and the most oppressive of governments, those people who are unfit, those people who are unjust, they will be their leaders over them. And then he went on to say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from the signs of the hour, وَلَمْ يَمْنَعُوا زَكَاةَ أَمْوَالِهِمْ, and they will not stop paying the zakat, they will not stop helping the needy, they will not stop giving in sadaqah. And this is the world we live in, my brothers and sisters, where we are worried about the climate and the environment. إِلَّا مُنِعُوا الْقَطَرَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will be prevented even from a raindrop from the skies. Everyone will be afflicted. وَلَوْلَا الْبَحَارِمْ, the Prophet ﷺ said, had it not been for the animals and the plants, لَمْ يُمْتَرُوا, they would not have been given rain or water from the skies. Then he went on to say, ﷺ, وَلَمْ يَنْقُدُ أَهْدُ اللَّهِ وَأَهْدُ الرَّسُولِ, and the religion of Allah and the religion of the Messenger of Allah ﷺ is not lost. إِلَّا صَلَّتَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ عَدُوٌ مِنْ غَيْرِهِمْ, except that Allah, as a result, will place upon the Muslims a weakness so that their enemies will overcome them. Today, my brothers and sisters, Muslims in the Middle East, today, my brothers and sisters, Muslims in Asia and in Europe and anywhere in the world, you will find them being overcome, them being victims of oppression, them being abused. But this is all, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, as an ummah, it is because we are far away from Allah and His Messenger. فَأَخَذَ بَعْدَ مَا فِي أَيْدِيهِمْ, and as a result, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Muslims will lose their numbers. The ummah will reduce. And some of the ulama have said that this means that their lands will be taken away from them, and their countries will then end up in turmoil. And then he went on to say, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ أَئِمَّتُهُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ, and the rulers that will come will be weak in the iman. And because they will be weak in the iman, they will only be selected from an ummah which is weak in its iman already. Rulers will be placed upon this ummah who are weak in iman because the ummah is weak in iman. The Muslim heads of state will slowly leave the legislation found in the Quran and the Sunnah. وَتَخَيَّرُوا فِيمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cause it as a division between the Muslims. إِلَّا جَعَلَ اللَّهُ بَأْسَهُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ, their countries will become divided, their opinions will become divided, they will know not what unity is anymore, people will lose hope in their rulers, and there will be turmoil. He also said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in another hadith, الطاعون, diseases and pandemics that spread the earth, رِجْسٌ أو أذابٌ أرسل على بني إسرائيل أو على من كان قبلهم. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, diseases, contagious illnesses were sent to Bani Israel and the nations before us as a way of Allah punishing them for the disobedience that they showed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters in Iman, in coronavirus, there is a sign for the people of Iman. Look how the world has changed over something which is not visible to the human eye. It is because the experts and the people of knowledge and the governments are saying that even though you can't see it, it is there, so protect yourself. So how about people of Iman, my brothers and sisters? We have the most knowledgeable of all creation, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, telling us about Iman in the unseen. So prepare for it and learn about it and implement your path back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In coronavirus also we learn that mankind and Bani Adam and jinn have become defenseless against shaitan. This is because there is something attacking us that we can't see. And we believe in it because scientists and governments are telling us that it's there. How about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us that we have an enemy that we can't see and he is there. And he attacks us and he knows how to attack us. So protect yourselves. For the people of Iman in coronavirus, my brothers and sisters, look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changes the state of the whole globe out of thin air. And this is how the Qadr of Allah is for the people of Iman. In coronavirus, my brothers and sisters, there is a sign for the people of Iman, for those who realize and want to change. How long will mankind continue sinning and ignoring the religion of Allah? But with this virus, my brothers and sisters, Allah's Qadr is forcing people to realize that they have to change. Allah's Qadr through this disease is stopping people from doing the sins that they want to do. And even the most sinful of people is thinking twice about the evil and the sin that he wants to carry out. Places of music stopped, public transport even stopped. People are thinking twice about what they want to do with their actions. And through the Qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has stopped a lot of munkar that is happening in the globe. And for the people of Iman, this is a sign. My brothers and sisters, Allah is showing us his power and his decree upon us. And this is because fitna and corruption and sin and shirk and kufr has spread this earth for far too long. Allah says in the Quran, ذَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْدَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقُرْآنِ وَالسُّنَّةِ أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروا إنه هو غفور رحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله إمام المرسلين فصلوات الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, my brothers and sisters, have taqwa of Allah and fear him and prepare by doing what Allah has commanded you to do and stay away from what he has told you to stay away from. But in this virus, my brothers and sisters, there's a glad tidings for Muslims and Muslim countries. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said that there is nothing that Allah has created that is purely bad. There may be something which is bad, but some good comes out of it. So in this coronavirus, there is good and there is bad. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, كَانَ أَذَابٌ يَبْعَثُ اللَّهُ عَلَى مَنْ يَشَاءُ, that these diseases is a punishment that he sends upon who he wants. فَجَعَلُ اللَّهُ رَحْمَةً لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ, however, for the believers, and it is a mercy. For the people of Iman, it is a mercy. But how can it be a mercy, my brothers and sisters? It can only be a mercy for the people who have Iman internally and they have taqwa externally. Those who are patient when they are going through difficulties in their lives. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, At-ta'un, those people who die out of these pandemics and these diseases, shahadatun li kulli muslim, no Muslim dies as a result of these diseases except through Allah's mercy upon him and a rahmah, that this person will be accepted as the shuhada, he will be guaranteed Jannah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in another hadith, and now this hadith describes largely the state of the Muslim ummah today. He said, فَنَاءُ أُمَّتِي, most of my ummah will die. Most of my ummah will perish by two things, بِالطَّعْنِ وَالطَّعُونَ, by being oppressively killed. sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is talking about his ummah. And this is what we can see in the world today. Most of my ummah will perish bit-ta'ni wat-ta'un. They will either be oppressively killed or by a disease. But in order for it to be a rahmah for us, in order for us to understand it and engage with it in a way that Allah is pleased with us, we need to abide by the religion of Allah. Because there is no ahkam in the religion of Allah except that it connects us to Allah and His pleasure. So step one, my brothers and sisters, don't panic. Be calm. Verify information. And it is not permissible for a Muslim to spread rumors. And it is not permissible for a Muslim to spread fear. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La yuhillu li Muslim." It is not permissible for a Muslim, أن يورع مسلما, that he causes panic, he causes fear, he causes tension in the life of another Muslim. This is because the Muslim is a person who is calm. The Muslim is a person of knowledge. So he verifies what he learns. But most of all, my brothers and sisters, a Muslim, he is optimistic and he spreads optimism. Step number two, don't go into an affected area. And if you are affected, don't leave that area. And this is the advice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, فَإِذَا سَمِئْتُمْ بِهِ أَرْضُ, if you hear of a pandemic in a land, فَلَا تَقْدُمُوهَا, then do not go to that land. It is haram for you to travel into that land. وَإِذَا وَقَعَ بِالْأَرْضُ, and if that disease occurs in a land that you are in, وَأَنْتُمْ بِهَا فَلَا تَخْرُجُوا فِرَارًا مِنْ, do not leave that country, do not leave that land seeking to get away from it. Step number three, my brothers and sisters, during the plague of Amwas, which was a plague that happened during the caliphate of Umar radiallahu anhu, a group of people came to see Abu Musa al-Ash'ari during that plague radiallahu anhu. They wanted to seek knowledge from him. But he said, don't stay in this city. فَقَدْ أُصِيبَ فِي الدَّارِ إِنسَانٌ بِهَذَا السَّقَمُ, there is a person in this city who has been afflicted by this virus. So don't stay here. فَتَخْرُجُوا فِي فَسِيهِ بَلَادِكُمْ, go back to the country that you came from. حَتَّى يَرْفَعَ هَذَا وَبَاءٌ, until this disease has been totally lifted. Allahu Akbar, my brothers and sisters. Allahu Akbar, my brothers and sisters. Abu Musa is saying, giving us advice for more than 1400 years ago, preserve your own personal hygiene and isolate yourselves. Preserve your own personal hygiene and isolate yourselves. This is the same information that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave to us. And now doctors are saying that the best way, centuries later, the best way that you can protect yourself from coronavirus is to preserve your own personal hygiene and to isolate yourselves. Step number four, my brothers and sisters, display patience. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us that if you fulfill the wajibat, it will be a protection for you. But he also taught us sallallahu alaihi wasallam different ruqyas, different athkar that you can do in the morning and the evening. And he told us that if you do them, there will be a form of protection for you. Your salawat will be a form of protection for you. Your manners will be a form of protection for you. Your goodness will be a form of protection for you. Your leaving off sins will be a protection for you. And all of this brings you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, what we learn from this also is that the Muslim, when he's connected to Allah, he doesn't need amulets to protect him. He doesn't need amulets for cure. He doesn't need amulets for barakah. The person of Allah needs only Allah. My brothers and sisters, how is it possible that our government, our doctors, the World Health Organization are all saying that you need to have rules and protocols so that you can be protected, and that this religion, which is the religion which is complete, doesn't have anything? Oh Allah, we ask you because you are Allah. We ask you because we have none but you. You are alive and you do not go away. Yours is the control and you are ever able. You do not sleep. You do not tire. We ask you, O Allah, for there is no God but you, to help Islam and the Muslims. To look after us, O Allah. To protect us, O Allah. O Allah, give honor to Islam and the Muslims. O Allah, give peace and comfort and security to our homes and to our communities. O Allah, remove our mistakes. O Allah, help us against our sins. O Allah, give us a good understanding. O Allah, allow us to get closer to you and preserve us and our communities and our youth. O Allah, help the Muslim Ummah wherever they are. because they have nothing now except dua. Oh Allah, help the Uyghurs in China. Oh Allah, help the Rohingya in Burma. Oh Allah, help the Syrians. Oh Allah, help the Palestinians. Oh Allah, help the people in Iraq and Libya and Yemen. Oh Allah, help the Muslims in India and in Kashmir. Oh Allah, help the Muslims in Delhi. Oh Allah, help our brothers and sisters who are being oppressed in Idlib. Oh Allah, help them because they have no place to go. Oh Allah, they are stranded at sea and there is no one there to help them. Oh Allah, give them security after fear. Oh Allah, help them and give them stable replacement, Ya Rabbul Alameen. Oh Allah, give us strength to our weak ones. Oh Allah, give us wealth to our poor ones. Oh Allah, give us health to the ones which we have are sick amongst us. Oh Allah, have mercy on our deceased and give us Jannah. Allahumma inna udhubika min junoon wal judham wal baras wa sayyir asqam. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Salamun ala al-mursaleen. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.